Good afternoon, everybody. My name is Ilgin Yorulmaz. I'm a freelance journalist and the secretary of FCCJ. I also co-chair the diversity committee at FCCJ to promote inclusion of underrepresented groups in Japanese society. We have two extraordinary individuals today with us. Eiko Kimura, on my immediate right, she is fighting for a better integration of disabled people into society. She has cerebral palsy. And Yasuhiko Funago, who is also fighting for the rights of people with disabilities. Now, you know, both of these individuals, both of these politicians made history when they were elected to the House of Councilors last year, as Tokyo prepares for the Paralympics, alongside the Olympics in 2021, we thought there is no better time for these two great trailblazers to come and speak at FCCJ and to make their case for why people with disabilities should enjoy the same rights as everyone else. The Cabinet Office in Japan says there are 9.6 million disabled people in Japan. The country became a signatory to the 2007 United Nations Convention on the Rights of Persons with Disabilities after years of campaigning by grassroots movements to make the society more open, accessible, and inclusive. However, problems remain. Despite the 2016 law banning discrimination against the physically and mentally disabled, both public and private sectors have yet to deliver on their promise of creating a more diverse work and life environment to accommodate these individuals. On this United Nations International Day of Persons with Disabilities, we are more than honored to hear Kimura-san and Funago-san to speak about their experiences and tell us as lawmakers how to make Japan more inclusive and how to make the people with disabilities more visible. Funago-san will speak through a computer device, and we have Mary Joyce as our interpreter for today. Without further ado, I would like to leave the floor to these two extraordinary individuals, and we will then follow it with question and answer. So first,
リンゴの紹介の方は省略させていただきますが、本日のスピーカーお二人の国会議員の木村先生、そして船越先生にお越しいただいております。まずは木村先生の方からお願いいたします。
皆さんこんにちは。令和新選組の木村英子です。私が国会議員になった経緯を少し今までのことも含めてお話ししたいと思います。
Good afternoon, everybody. My name is Eiko Kimura, and I'm a member of the Reiwa Shinsengumi. I would like to speak to you today about my path to becoming a member of the Japanese Diet.
私は生後8ヶ月の時に障害を負い、幼少期のほとんどを親から離れ、施設と養護学校で育ちました。
I suffered my disability when I was 8 months old, and I spent most of my early childhood years separated from my parents, being raised in an institution and a school for persons with disabilities.
子どもの頃の施設ではリハビリと手術を繰り返す毎日で、日常的に職員からの虐待も受けたことがあります。介護の必要な重度障害者は養護学校を卒業しても親が介護をできない場合はほとんどが施設に入れられてしまいます。
So in the institution of my childhood, I spent my days in a repeat of rehabilitation and surgery, also being routinely abused by staff. Most people living with severe disabilities and in need of care are placed in institutions when their parents are unable to provide care for them, even after they graduate from school.
私も例外ではなく、養護学校高等部を卒業後、次に入る施設が決まっていましたが、度重なる虐待や施設での隔離生活に耐えられず、親や教師の勧める施設には絶対に行きたくありませんでした。
I was no exception from this. after graduating, the next facility that I was to enter had already been decided. However, being unable to stand the frequent abuse and also the isolation in the institution, I therefore did not want to go to a facility which was recommended by my parents and teachers.
そんな時、同じ重度障害者で施設を飛び出し、地域での自立生活を実現している存在を知り、私も彼女のように地域で自立した生活がしたいと思い、施設を拒絶し、地域へ飛び出していきました。
However, at that time when I learned of someone who was living with a severe disability but living independently in the community, I wanted to also live a life as she was. Therefore, I rejected the institution and ventured out into the community.
私が地域に飛び出した時は、介護保障の制度はほとんどありませんでしたが、施設から地域へ出た障害者たちが権利運動を行い、東京都や国に介護保障を作らせていきました。
When I first went out into the community, there was almost no system for care or welfare in place. However, people living with disabilities who had themselves left institutions and ventured out into the community were campaigning, including also for human rights and in this movement.And thanks to this campaign, the Tokyo Metropolitan and the national governments then did implement systems for care.
それが自立と社会参加を目的として、障害者の地域での生活全般を支える介護制度として生まれ、時代とともに制度が変わっていき、今の障害者総合支援法の重度訪問介護などの制度になっています。
And so this care system was initially established to ensure that people living with disabilities could enjoy the same level of independence and social participation as those without. This care system was first implemented under the Basic Act for Persons with Disability. Following this, it changed over time as time progressed to become the current system, which is known as the 重度訪問介護 or the visiting care for persons with severe disability.
しかし、今現在使っている制度は当時から運用が変わっておらず、トイレとか着替え、入浴、居宅内での介護が中心であり、最低限度の外出は散歩とかに限られている制度で、障害者の社会参加が現在制限されている現状です。
However, the operation of this system has not changed over the time which has passed.In principle, all it allows for is care services such as toilet facilities, changing clothes, and bathing in the home. However, the social participation of people with disabilities outside of the home is extremely limited.
昨年私が選挙に当選し、いざ参議院での仕事をしようとした時も、この制度は就学と就労が認められていない制度であったために、党員すらできず、国会活動が事実上できない状況になってしまいました。
When I was elected last year and attempted to go to work in the House of Councillors, this system did not even provide for work or study. Therefore, I was unable to even attend the diet, and parliamentary activities were virtually impossible.
皮肉にも私が当選したことをきっかけに、日本の障害者が健常者と同じような当たり前の権利、地域での生活とか就学就労など全ての面において生きにくい現状が世間に明らかになりました。
So in what is perhaps a coincidence, my election has made it clear to the public that people with disabilities in Japan have the same rights to be taken for granted as those who do not have disabilities. However, the fact that in regards to, for example, them living, working, and studying in the community, there are various factors which make it extremely difficult.
障害者が地域社会で生きていくために必要な住宅、交通、教育、就労、介護などあらゆる場面において健常者と同じ権利が保障されていない現状がある中、特に私のような常に介護を必要な重度障害者にとっては社会参加に欠かすことのできない介護保障が不十分であり、日常生活や就労、就学など今日の日本においては当たり前の権利が十分に保障されていない現状があります。
People with disabilities do not now have the same rights as those without in all aspects of life in a community, including housing, transportation, education, employment, and nursing care. Particularly for people such as myself with severe disabilities who need constant care.The nursing care coverage that is essential in order to have social participation is now inadequate. And the rights in Japan which are taken for granted today, such as for daily life, employment, and schooling, are not fully guaranteed for people with disabilities.
1981年に国際障害者年に掲げられた完全参加と平等の理念を実現していくために参議院議員として日本の障害者に対する社会的バリアを一つ一つ取り除いていく活動をしていくことが私の役割であると思っています。
As a member of the House of Councillors, I believe that it is my role to work to break down one by one the social barriers to people living with disabilities in Japan in order to realize the idea of full participation and equalityWhich was set forth in the International Year of Disabled Persons in
1981.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much, Kuma-san. You're from Kuma-san, please. Whenever you are ready. 皆様、こんにちは。令和新選組参議院議員の船越康彦でございます。日本における障害者の人権や現状についてお話しする機会をいただきありがとうございます。私は宝石や時計を扱う商社マンとして働いていた2000年に筋縮性側索硬化症 ALS と診断されました。当初は全身麻痺になって人の世話になって生きるくらいなら死んでしまいたいと考えていました。しかし ALS と宣告されたばかりの患者さんに自分の経験を話すピアサポートの活動をして自分にはまだやることがあると思い直し、2002年に人工呼吸器をつけ生き延びる選択をしました。その後障害者施設に入所していた時、また施設を出て自立生活を始めた当初、ネグレクトや不適切なケアを経験し、同じ人間なのに健常者と障害者と分断され、障害者が不幸な世の中はおかしいと考えるようになりました。そこで地元の松野市議選に出馬しました。その時は落選しましたが、昨年の参議院選挙で令和新選組から比例特定枠候補として立候補して初当選しました。現在インクルーシブ教育保育の実現や障害者が地域で暮らし働くための法制度整備環境整備に取り組んでいます。
Hello everybody, I am Funago Yasuhiko, a member of the House of Councillors from the Reiwa Shinsen GumiThank you for the opportunity today to speak to you about the human rights and current situation of people living with disabilities in Japan. In the year 2000, when I was working for a trading company dealing in jewelry and watches, I was diagnosed with ALS, amyotrophic lateral sclerosis. At first, I thought that I would rather die than live with total paralysis and under the care of others. However, through participating in peer support activities, sharing my own experience with people who have just been diagnosed with ALS, I was reminded that there was yet more that I still had to do. Therefore, in 2000, I made the choice to survive and was fitted with an artificial ventilator. Later, when I was in an institution for people with disabilities, and after leaving there and at the beginning of living independently, I experienced both neglect and inappropriate care. I began to think that it was wrong to live in a world where there were divisions between people living with disabilities and those without the rest of the population, and the kind of situation where people with disabilities were forced into unhappy circumstances. Therefore, I ran for the local Matsudo City Council. While I was unsuccessful in that election, I was elected for the first time in last year's House of Councillors election as a candidate on the proportional list from the Reiwa Shinsengumi. At present, I am working on the realization of inclusive education and childcare, and the development of legislation and an environment where people living with disabilities can live and work in the community.
日本の障害者の人権現状に関して最初に指摘したいのは、日本は諸外国と比べ入所施設、精神科病院に入っている人の数が多く、その入所年数が極めて長いことです。施設から地域に出て定員が空いても、すぐに新規の入所者で埋められます。結果的にこの15年間で身体障害者施設は 18.9 万人から 7.3 万人まで減っていますが、知的障害者は13万人から 13.2 万人で微増、精神障害者は 34.5 万人から30万人と微減です。こうした中で2016年、相模原市の知的障害者施設津久井山ゆり園で元職員が障害者19人を殺害する事件が起きました。この事件は施設の閉じられた環境、固定化された関係性の問題と、施設を必要とする地域社会の問題を象徴する事件だと私は捉えています。2点目に、障害者関連の法制度は比較的整っていますが、都市部と地方との格差は大きく、また運用面の問題があります。私のような進行性難病で人工呼吸器を使い自立生活をしている方は、欧米と比較して日本は多いと思います。それは国民皆保険の医療保険の下で人工呼吸器のレンタルが可能となり、地域で暮らす上で必要な地域医療、訪問看護、長時間介護が可能な重度訪問介護制度があるからです。これらの制度は当事者、家族の長い運動の成果であります。しかし市区町村が必要なサービス時間を認めてくれない、訪問看護、重度訪問介護サービスを提供できる事業所、人材が不足し、家族に負担がかかり、比較的サービスが厚い東京などの都市部に引っ越さざるを得ないという状況があります。3点目に、障害者に対する意識のバリアが未だに厚いと感じています。例えば知的障害があるお子さんや医療的ケアの必要なお子さんが地域の学校に通いたいと希望すると、ネット上で障害のない子どもに迷惑がかかる、わがままだという批判が上がります。また職場では障害のある人と一緒に働く際にどのように接していいのかわからないということもあります。私個人の経験では、国会議員になった後、ある国会議員から聞こえているのと言われたことがあります。またインターネット上で、言葉を話せない障害者に議員が務まるわけがないと中傷されたことがあります。
With regard to the issue of the human rights of people with disabilities in Japan, the first issue I would like to point out is that the number of people in residential institutions and psychiatric hospitals in Japan is higher than in other countries. And furthermore, the number of years that they spend there is extremely long. Even if a vacancy occurs after someone leaves the facility to go into the community, it is quickly filled by new admissions.As a result, or over the last 15 years, although facilities for people with physical disabilities have decreased from 189,000 to 73,000, those for persons with intellectual disabilities have increased slightly from 130,000 to 132,000, and those for people with mental or mental health disabilities have decreased slightly from 345,000 to 300,000.It was within this context that in the year 2016, a former employee murdered 19 people with disabilities at the Tsukui Yamayurien, a facility for people with intellectual disabilities in Sagamihara City. I see this incident as being symbolic of the problems both of the closed environment and fixed relationships of such facilities, and the community which makes such facilities necessary.Secondly, although the legal system for people with disabilities is relatively well developed in Japan, there is a large disparity between urban and rural areas, and there are also various operational problems. Compared to Europe and the United States, I believe that there are more people in Japan, such as me, who have progressive intractable diseases and live independently using a ventilator.This is because it is possible to rent a ventilator under the medical insurance provided under the National Health Insurance. And further, there is a system of various services needed in order to live in the community, such as medical care or home visit nursing, and also long-term care for those with severe diseases. These systems are the result of long campaign by persons with disabilities themselves and also their families.However, there is still a situation in which, for example, municipalities do not recognize the required hours for this care, the service hours, or a shortage of both providers and also staff who can provide the home nursing and severe home care services. This therefore puts a burden on families and forces people, for example, to move to urban areas such as Tokyo, where services are relatively more extensive.Third, I feel that there is also still a thick barrier of awareness about persons with disabilities. For example, if a child with intellectual disabilities or medical needs wishes to attend a school in the community, he or she may be criticized online for bothering children without disabilities or for being selfish. Also, in the workplace, many people do not know how to interact with persons with disabilities when working together.In my own personal experience, after becoming a member of parliament, I was asked by another member, can you even hear? Or I have also been slandered on the internet with comments such as, how can a disabled person who cannot even speak be a parliamentarian?
この意識の壁は日本が1976年に養護学校を義務化し、障害のある子とない子を分ける教育を続けてきたため、日常的に障害のある人と触れ合うことなく過ごしてきてしまったことが大きいと考えています。1点目に挙げた施設入所が減らない理由も、小さい時から地域の同世代と一緒に学び育っていないために、親も障害のある子も地域社会で頼れる人間関係がないことが大きいと思います。私は日本の障害者の状況を変える一番の方法は、小さい時から一緒に学び育つインクルーシブ保育教育と考え、制度転換を実現したいと考えております。ご清聴ありがとうございました。
I believe that this barrier or this wall of awareness is largely due to the fact that Japan in the year 1979 made special needs schools compulsory and has continued to separate children with and without disabilities. This means that people are not in daily contact with people who are living with disabilities. The reason that institutionalization, as I mentioned in my first point, has not decreased.Is because people with disabilities have not had the opportunity to learn and grow up with their peers in the community from a young age. This also means that parents of children with disabilities also therefore do not have the human relationships in the community upon which they can rely. I believe that the best way in order to change the situation of people living with disabilities in Japan is to be able to learn and grow together from an early age. Therefore, I would like to achieve a change in the system in order to realize such inclusive childcare and inclusive education. Thank you very much for your attention.
Thank you very much, Akimura-san and Kanago-san, for these very different but similar in some ways and amazing stories, because we able-bodied do not understand the kind of difficulties you are going through. So I would like to now, please.
今日お二人非常に貴重なお話もありがとうございます。お二人の経験の中にはもちろん違う点、そして共通する点はたくさんあるかと思うんですけれども、直接経験していない私たちにとってはなかなか知らないような状況もたくさんありますので、本日本当に貴重な話ありがとうございます。
If I may first ask a question as the moderator, you mentioned both of you actually neglect andinappropriate care during the time you were institutionalized. Can you maybe remember, not necessarily from that time, but from your general experience, one specific incident, one thing that got you to decide to run for politics?
まず司会の方からお二人に質問をさせていただきます。お二人の話の中では二人ともそのネグレクト、虐待などというお話があったんですけれども、それについて詳細のご経験について伺うことというよりも、政治家になろうと思ったきっかけということはやはりそういったようなご体験などにもつながっているような部分があったのか、もしくは政治家になろうと思ったきっかけについて教えていただければと思います。
木村です、ね。私が政治家になりたかったという理由ですけれども、まずその私は19歳で養護学校を卒業して地域に飛び出してきました。それは先ほど言ったように施設には絶対に行きたくなかったからです。でしかしその社会の中には重度の障害者が生きていけるための保障はあまりありません。ですので私が地域で生きるためにはその介護者を探すために大学や街頭でビラをまいてボランティアを探すところから始まりました。でそこでその私にとってその地域生活の中で一番やらなければならなかったことはまず行政との交渉でした。行政に対して介護保障してくれっていうことをこの36年間ずっと障害者運動として仲間と共にやってきました。
ではまずそこまで通訳させていただきます。はい。
So the reason why I decided that I wanted to become a politician goes back to, as I introduced in my speech, when I was 19 years old, I left the facility and went to live out in the community. This is because I did not want to remain in institutions after that. However, after going out into society, I realized that the kind of support or care welfare provided for persons such as myself who are living with severe disabilities was very thin.In order to live in the community, I first had to seek care as myself. Therefore, I would be going to universities or even on the street handing out flyers to seek volunteers who would be able to work with me as my carers. For me, to live into the community, the thing which was also one of the biggest issues was the negotiations with the government or the administration in order to have the necessary support to be provided.And therefore, for 36 years, I was involved in this movement led by persons with disabilities themselves in order to have this care.
地域で生きていくときに、行政交渉には限界がありました。なので、やはりその行政に対して介護保障を要求していくだけでは、なかなか福祉が進展していかない中で、そんな中、その運動のさなかにですね、 山本太郎さんに出会いました。そして中度の障害者が自身がですね、政治に参加することで福祉を変えたり世の中を変えていけるのではないかということ、そして一緒に政治を変えましょうというお話をいただいて、私はこの運動をするだけではなく政治に当事者として参加することで変えていくことができると思って勇気を持って参加しました。
However, living in the community, I felt or I came across various limitations and so on as to what could be achieved within these negotiations with the local governments and so on. For example, no matter how many requests we could be making to the local government for the sufficient care and so on to be provided, unless the overall welfare system itself could be changed, then this was rather difficult to implement. It was at that time when I met Yamamoto Taro.And he spoke to me or appealed to me about the fact that if someone who was living with severe disabilities could themselves directly be involved in politics, there would be the potential for changing this welfare system and also changing society overall. Therefore, after I received this offer from him in order to work together to indeed change politics, I decided that there was indeed change which could be done directly from the inside from being involved as a politician myself and I found the courage to take him up on that.
Thank you very much. Nanda-san, I'd like to say a few words, please.
Nagoka, これまで話してきた内容と今文字盤で表現した内容を織り交ぜて代読させていただきます。
So I will be reading both from some remarks which have been shared by Mr. Funibo and also some which he has just shared on the letters reading now on his behalf.
Thank you.
では代読いたします。スピーチで話したことに加えて申しますと、2012年に隣にいる介助者で看護師のさずかに出会い、さずかが経営する、福祉事業介護、看護介護事業会社の役員副社長に就任することになりました。
And so initially to add some further information after what I shared in my speech in the year 2000, I encountered someone who had been working in nursing facility and I was appointed actually as the deputy in charge of particular care facility.
そこでサービスを受ける側から提供する側の福祉の現場も学びました。この経験を政治の場で生かしたいと考え、スピーチで申し上げた市議選に挑戦いたしました。
And so therefore, from shifting from someone who was on the recipient side of these care services to being involved in working on the field for an organization which was providing such care services, I wanted to see what I experienced on both sides of this within the field in politics. Therefore, that was why I decided to run in the local election, as I mentioned in my speech.
落選しましたが、政治への意欲は諦めることができず、昨年の参議院選挙に出まして当選することができました。
Well, I was not successful in that first local election. My motivation to enter politics did not disappear. Indeed, it grew from there, not giving up. Therefore, I decided to stand in last year's House of Councillors election, where I was indeed elected.
私の活動のスローガンは、人間の可能性はノーリミットというものです。私が国会で必要な支援と介助を得て活動することで、さまざまな人にこのことを知ってもらい、障害者が生きやすい社会は全ての人にとって生きやすい社会だということを訴え、そうした社会に変えていけることだと考えております。
My slogan is that there are no limits to a person's potential. Therefore, I believe the fact that I am able to be active in the diet while receiving the necessary care and support to do so.Is something which can demonstrate that fact to people. A society which is easy to live in for persons with disabilities is also easy to live in for all people. Therefore, I am now doing what I can within the diet to change society and make that a reality.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Now I'd like to open the floor for any comments or any questions if you have any. Can you please introduce yourself?
まずお名前とご所属の方もお願いします
。エドバラのチョン・グリンダイ。Thank you so much for coming to the club in the pandemic. It's very, very much appreciated. I'd like to ask, you've been in Parliament for just over a year now, and I think your presence has been a great symbolic effect in Japan, and I'm sure a great inspiration to many disabled people. Can you tell us about anyprogress towards the goals that you have of increasing the improving the environment for inclusivity for disabled people in Japan.
ブルームバーグのイザベル・レノズと申します。本日は本当にコロナ禍の中でこちらにお越しいただきありがとうございます。お二人が国会議員になられて1年少しが経ちますが、その中で本当に日本社会において非常に象徴的な大きなインスピレーションになられているというふうに感じております。この1年では障害を持つ人たちにとって日本がよりインクルーシブ、より生きやすい社会にするためにはどういったような進展があったのかについて伺いしたいと思います。
木村です。まだ私は、議員になって1年ですので、本当に障害者の人が地域で生きやすくなる社会を作っていくっていうスタートを切ったばかりです。でそういう中で、そうですね、良くなっていくこと、そうですね、やっぱりその私が今やっていることは、今国土交通省に所属しているんですけれども、私ができる、私が障害を持ってバリアと感じることができる、それを改善していくということについては、新幹線の車椅子スペースの席を増やしたりとか、あるいはその視覚障害者の人たちの点字ブロックでを一緒に視察させてもらって、実際に転落事故も起きていますので、そういうことを質問に挙げたりとか、そういうことをしながら一つ一つ解決していく中で、今少しでも障害者の人が地域で生きやすい現状を改善していけたらと思って活動しています。
So for me it is just one year now since I joined the National Parliament. Therefore I believe in terms of making a change for people living with disabilities in the community, we are really just standing at the starting line now. There have been some improvements that we have seen within this. For example, I am personally affiliated with committees relating to the Ministry of Transportation. And so in regards to that, we have been doing what we can to make small changes to remove some of the barriers which are in place for persons living with disabilities. For example, increasing the number of wheelchair accessible spaces on the Shinkansen trains as one example. Also looking at increasing the, for example, braille signage and so on for visually impaired persons. There have been, of course, incidents of persons falling and so on, incidents because of the lack of such support in place as well. Therefore, on the opportunity in the Diet to pose such questions about these concrete improvements which can be made, and one by one to deal with how to resolve these barriers which are in place for persons with disabilities in order to little by little make an environment in which it is easier to live.
Thank you. Okay, thank you. And if I may ask maybe a question while we're waiting for Funaga-san, with his response. I know that the national government has one severe long-term care system that allows severe victims to use this long-term care, including medical care, but it cannot be used for year-round and long-term outings, such as going for work or school, commuting. This seems to be a problem. I don't know if Kimura-san would like to comment on this barrier.
今のご質問は後ほどまた船子さんにお聞きしたいと思いますが、その前に木村先生に一つ司会の方から質問させていただきます。お話の中でその重度訪問介護などについての説明があったかと思うんですけれども、日本ではまだその年中、そしてまあ就労ですとか就学などのためのケアがまだその制度の中では提供されていないという現状があるというふうに理解をしていますが、もしそうであればそれは問題というふうに思われますが、それについてもう少し詳しい話をお伺いしたいです。
この重度訪問介護っていう制度は、障害者の人が地域に出てきたその1970年代にですね、施設収容っていうのが当たり前の時代でした。でその時に障害者の人たちが施設の中で非人間的な扱いを受けて、そこでそこの非人間的な生活をこう抗議してですね、地域へ出てきて、そしてその時に行政と交渉してできたのが脳性麻痺者介護人派遣事業という制度、重度脳性麻痺者介護人派遣事業というものを行政に作らせました。で、
So first of all, this kind of system for persons living with disabilities in the community to have support in place was first introduced from the 1970s, but at that time institutionalization was still taken for granted, or that was the norm for persons with disabilities. However, going up and again, looking at the situation of the inhumane treatment which people were experiencing in such institutions, going against that,more people wanted to instead live in the community, therefore entered into negotiations with the administration, government, and so on in order to have this visiting care system initially introduced.
その当時は施設から地域へ出る、そして地域で生きるための保障というものを要求してきました。で、その制度が当時は4時間ぐらい、1日4時間ぐらいから始まり、徐々に増えていったんですけれども、国際障害者年も煽ってですね、その制度を使いながら障害者の人が施設から地域へ出てくる障害者が増えてきました。そして今の日本のその障害者の人たちは施設ではなく地域で暮らしていける状況に少しずつなってはきましたけれども、先ほど言ったようにこの制度が今現在はいろいろなその制度の変革によって重度訪問介護という名前になって存在していますけれども、70年代にそのできた制度から変わっていないところは居宅介護のみというところが変わっていません。家の中でトイレ着替え入浴といった身辺介護を重視しています。で外出はほとんどではないんですけれども、最近少しずつ認められてはきていますが、まだまだ旅行とかですね、あるいは余暇活動といった、あるいはその政治活動、宗教活動とかですね、そういうことは認められていません。ですからその自立はした、地域で自立はしたといっても、やはりその一人の人間として健常者と同じ当たり前の権利というのはまだまだ保障されていません。
Following this, the number of people who were moving from institutions to live in community gradually did increase. Therefore, according with this or accompanying this, we also made our demand in regards to the kind of needs and support which needed to be in place in order to live in the community.When the system was initially put in place, it started from care being provided for 4 hours a day, and this number of hours gradually increased from then. The International Year for Persons with Disabilities was a moment when the number of people using this system or living out in the community did increase significantly within Japan. And since then, there have been some small amounts of changes and some small situations of more and more people living with disabilities outside of facilities and instead in the community. However, while there has been various reform or changes made to this system along the years, leading it to now being known as the system, as I mentioned, the 重度訪問介護, or the visiting care for persons with severe disabilities, the fact which has not changed since the 1970s is that generally this is only looking at care to be provided in the home. It is looking at, for example, the focus on care for going to the bathroom, for changing, for bathing, and so on, and has very little in place in order for going outside of the home. This is gradually changing little by little. However, things, for example, such as traveling, such as working, such as being involved in politics are not included or recognized under this current care system still. Therefore, it can be said that while we are saying that there are more people living in the community, the situation of persons living with disabilities in the community actually enjoying or experiencing the same rights as people without disabilities, as you know, one individual, as a person in the community, is unfortunately still far from the case.
Thank you. 障害者の権利が認められないといっても、さまざまな障害者がいます。で、私が言っているこの重度訪問介護という制度は、特にその1日24時間介護が必要な障害者の人の介護制度ということです。で、やはりその介護が必要な障害者の人っていうのは、やはり権利を保障されることが少ないので、一番その制度の狭間にある存在でもあります。ですから私の役割としては、介護の必要な障害者の人が地域で当たり前に生きていけるこの介護制度である重度訪問介護の充実をこれから行政に対し、あるいは国に対して保障を訴えていきたいというふうに思っております。
However, when we talk about the rights of persons with disabilities, of course there are many different kinds of disabilities and many different people as well. This system or the particular situation which I'm speaking about is for those persons with severe disabilities who require care 24 hours a day or close thereto. These persons who need this kind of care are indeed those whose rights are very rarely guaranteed within society and the ones who are the most left out of the system as well. Therefore, I believe that my role in order to create a society where persons who do need care as well can live as others do within the community, and that this can be, you know, taken for granted, this can be a normal situation, is to look at how we can make that possible through changing this system, through changing both the local and the national government levels.
Thank you. Now, if I may go back to Funago-san, and the question, just to recap, the question was, as a member of parliament for more than a year now, how much progress do you think you have made toward the changes that are needed to make Japan a more inclusive country for the disabled, and what difficulties have you faced?
Yeah, Funago-san, please. 代読いたします。当選からの約1年間で、所属する文教科学委員会で計16回質疑を行い、質問主意書の提出や各種要望活動などにも積極に取り組んできました。また委員会活動以外でも医療的ケア児を支援する法案作成にも携わりました。諸先輩方にはまだまだ及びませんが、国会議員としての役割を果たすべく行動してまいりました。
In the approximately 1 year since I was elected and became a member of the Diet, I have posed questions during the question time at the Diet on 16 occasions, also submitted written requests and also various demands and so on to the government as well actively. Also being involved, for example, in the drafting of a law regarding to require medical care. While there is still a long way to go, and I perhaps am not yet able to follow the footsteps of those who have gone before me, I believe that I am doing all that I can in my position as a member of the Diet in order to work towards these goals.
Thank you. どうぞ。
国会議員として1年間を送り、周囲の議員の方々の反応も変わってきたように思います。当選当初は心ない言葉を投げかけられたこともありましたし、私でなく介助者に声をかけてくる人もいましたが、今はそのようなことはほぼなくなりました。
Also within the 1 year I have spent as a diet member, I have seen various changes within the diet. For example, the reactions or attitudes of fellow diet members as well. Well, in the early days, sometimes there were harsh words directed towards me, or people would, instead of speaking directly to me, they would speak to my carers. Now this situation is barely the case at all.
今後については、私たち障害者、難病患者もより良い生活を求めるため、強く一丸となって主張していくことを呼びかけたいと思います。そのためにも、諸外国の状況を皆様にもぜひお教えいただきたいと思います。
From now, in order to ensure that persons who are living with disabilities or also severe illnesses and so on can have this kind of better situation within the community, within society, I will continue to strive to do all that I can towards that goal. And I also hope that we can receive various information about the situation in other countries and so on as references or resources towards this as well.
Thank you, Nagasan. I'm just wondering, and if I may again ask another question, this event is being live streamed, and pandemic means that all of us know the word Zoom, and we are always on Zoom. Children are learning from Zoom. Is the diet on the Zoom, online or not, which may help with people with disabilities to basically join their sessions more comfortably?
もう一つ司会の方から質問させていただきます。本日の会見もオンラインで中継をしておりますが、やはりコロナ禍になりまして、Zoom ですとかオンライン会議などが学校なども職場などもいろいろと増えていると思います。その中でまず国会の方ではそういったような Zoom などのオンラインの、討議や会議などというものは行われているのかということ、そしてもしそうであれば、例えばそういったオンラインという形式が障害のある人たちにとってはもっと参加しやすいようなことがあるかどうかについてお伺いします。
ですね、国会では今オンラインではないですけれども、総理大臣が他の外国の首相の方とお話しするときはあるのかもしれませんけれども、私の場合、議員の場合は今現在ないです。
In regards to whether the diet at the moment it's not being held online, I think that, for example, some meetings which the Prime Minister is holding with leaders of other countries, these are being held virtually. But in my own case, as a diet member, this has not been the case. There is not this shift to online.
しかし、やはり障害がありますので、このコロナの、時期も踏まえてですね、やはりオンラインで参加する、政治参加するということはとても必要なことだと思います。やはり体調的にも障害的にもハンディがありますので、そこはこれから政府の方に検討していただきたいなというふうに思っております。
However, as someone living with a disability, particularly during this period of the coronavirusI think that it is more necessary to be able to provide online participation in politics. And I think that this is something particularly for someone who is living with such physical disabilities and so on. I hope that this is something which can be introduced.
We have about 3 minutes. And is that really perfect? Okay, so we'll take answer.
はい、代読いたします。新型コロナウイルスの感染拡大が広がっていた直後、私はオンライン出席を求めるよう要望を行っています。
Since the initial or the early days of the immediate spread of the contagion of the new coronavirus, I was calling for or requesting that online participation would be possible.
実際に私が福祉会社で働いていた時もオンラインによって会議に出席をしたり、朝礼を行っていたりもしました。
And actually, when I was previously working in the welfare care related company, I was able to participate in meetings or the morning staff gatherings and so on virtually.
新型コロナウイルスの感染拡大によって国会に出席できるかの瀬戸際に立たされました。私は ALS の進行によって呼吸する力が弱まり人工呼吸器を装着しています。免疫力が健康な人よりも低く感染しやすい上、感染すると重症化しやすいためです。
As the situation of the contagion, the COVID-19 cases have been increasing and so on, I have called for the participation or the possibility for attending the diet online to be made. As someone who is living with ALS, which is of course also impacting the respiratory functions, this means that I am living using an artificial ventilator and I have therefore a higher risk of contagion than perhaps people who have higher immune and are not. Already with this kind of situation. Not only this, the risk of contagion, but also the risk of contracting a more severe symptoms and so on if I were to contract the virus.
現在はオンラインによる遠隔出席は認められていませんが、職責や国民の負託に応えるためにも、委員会質疑や法案の採決に出たいと思っていますので、遠隔出席の実現は不可欠だと考えています。
So at the moment, remote participation or online participation has not yet been permitted. However, to ensure that I can continue full participation in, for example, the debates on lawmaking and also the presentations, discussions on behalf of the constituency and so on, I very much hope that this will indeed be made possible.
遠隔出席は障害者や難病患者だけの問題でなく、子育て中の方や家族の介護をしている方にとっても有効です。多様性のある社会実現のため、多様な働き方を国会でこそ実現したいと考えております。
And I believe that such virtual or remote participation is not only an issue and not only beneficial for persons who are living with disabilities, also for people who are in the midst of raising their children, for example, or who are providing care for family members as well. Allowing such forms of participation will indeed be important for ensuring that there can be the diversity needed within society.
Thank you. And with that, we thank both Eiko Kimura and Yasuhiko Funago for coming here today and for showing us that there are definitely no limits to a person's potential. Thank you so much. And as a token of our appreciation, I would like to present
本日はお二人のスピーカー本当にありがとうございます。本当先ほどのスローガンにありましたノーリミットっていうのは本当にお二人が、すごくお話の中で非常に、象徴してくださったと思います。でこちらはこちらの協会の1年間の名誉会員証をお渡ししますのでまたぜひお越しください。
どうぞ
船子議員から代読頼まれております。
最後に一言申し上げたく存じます。本日の記者会見の趣旨とは異なりますが、現在党として取り組んでおります新型コロナに伴う医療現場の供給体制強化に関して、政府に対して緊急の申し入れを行う予定です。ご興味をお持ちの方、ご興味いただければ幸いです。
And so I have one final remark I would like to make. It's not directly related to the presentation or the topic of today. However, our party is going to be submitting soon an emergency request to the government in regards for medical provision and so on for the COVID-19 situation. If anybody, or I hope that people can also be interested in that plan, and please approach us for more information if you would like.
Thank you so much, Kimura-san. Thank you so much, Nagasa-san.
Thank you.